New at 5, the Michael Jackson wrongful death trial focusing on the agreement with the pop star's doctor, Conrad Murray. Eyewitness News reporter Miriam Hernandez tells us that contract could be a key element in the case.
If Michael Jackson's death was caused by his doctor, then whoever hired the doctor for the star's comeback tour should be liable for his death, according to Katherine Jackson's lawsuit. Now under scrutiny before the jury, Dr. Conrad Murray's independent contractor agreement, drawn up by AEG but never signed. The AEG defense says the document holds evidence that Jackson requested Murray to be his personal physician and dictated his salary. Attorney Kathy Jory, who wrote the agreement, walked the jury through the many changes made to the document. Her appearance set off objections from the Jackson attorneys.
She never spoke to Michael Jackson. She doesn't know. But we know that, at least based on the evidence, that AEG did hire Dr. Murray. And the contract that she negotiated was never sent to any representatives of Michael Jackson.
The defense says Joy spoke directly to Murray about the terms the doctor and Jackson wanted.
Michael Jackson wanted to bring his longtime physician with him, that it was at his sole and absolute direction, that this would only occur with his not only saying that he wanted it done, but he actually had to sign and say so, and had to sign and say that he'd be the one paying for it.
Joy says she questioned Murray's salary, $150,000 a month. Murray's response, she testified, was that his practices in four states brought him $1 million a month. Jory says she did an internet search, found Murray's practices listed, and that the medical boards in the four states showed no record of disciplinary action against him. Jurors learned through earlier testimony that Murray was broke. About Murray's contract not being signed, the Jackson attorneys say it doesn't matter.
You don't really need a contract to hire someone. As we've seen in this case, many people have worked for AEG that didn't have a contract.
But AEG's interpretation of the law is that the unsigned agreement nullifies everything.
As long as you have that agreement, that you're not going to have an agreement unless signed by the parties, then you can't override that.
Jory returns to the stand tomorrow for more cross-examination by the Jackson attorneys. Miriam Hernandez, ABC7 Eyewitness News.